Hey, welcome to my computer. Welcome to lesson number 5. And in this lesson, as I mentioned before, we're going to be speaking about the competitor brand names. And again, this is a sneaky technique and it's against terms of service to use it, but it's up to you. I do use it, but again, it's something Amazon does not allow. If you want to try it, you're welcome. If you're not, then at least watch and see how it works because it might be useful for you. And the idea is, again, to find competitor brand names, as I mentioned in Magnet in the lesson number 1, but I just wanted to clarify it a bit deeper in this lesson. And once we find those keywords in the Magnet, we want to save them. Once you're going to be searching through your Magnet. But in this lesson, I also want to show you which competitor brand names are to use and which are not, which are going to be more beneficial to us and which are not going to be really beneficial to us. And for this, we're going to need 2 things. We're going to need the Magnet and Amazon and Xray. So let's sign in again into Helium 10. Here we have the Magnet. If you've missed, there's lesson number 1 for Magnet that we have spoken previously, and it's all going to be linked in the playlist for this free course, which are now on the free course of Helium 10 optimization. So we're now in Magnet, which is the keyword research, and the next thing we need to do is to find those competitor brand names. And usually, how do we find them and what is competitor brand names at all? So the thing is, sometimes after a while on the platform, a specific brand is gonna get name, you know, it's gonna get more searches, people are gonna speak word to mouth, and people are gonna start searching for this product with the brand name. So for example, let's take a kitchen knife, and there's gonna be a brand name Super Knives, and with time Super Knife is gonna get more sales, it's gonna be more known in the social media, it's gonna be known more amongst the customers that bought it, and they're just gonna go and say, you know, this Super Knives brand is super cool, so go and buy it, people are gonna search for it and stuff like that. And this will sort of develop a new keyword on the platform, and we can technically take advantage of that and rank for this keyword as well. Again, it's TOS, as I mentioned before, but pretty nice technique. Let me show you how to do it in the best way, because not always the brands that are gonna appear are gonna be useful for us. So let me explain you exactly what I mean. So we have the Magnet open, let's go to amazon.com and type in kitchen knife, right, as we previously did, kitchen knife. We have all the, you know, the kitchen knives. And again, I'm going to open the X-ray. If you have landed on this lesson for the first time, or you're not exactly sure, it's going to be up here, link in the description, a lesson about X-ray, which is not connected to the course. It's a general lesson that I've created for X-ray. There you can deeply search, learn about this tool. But again, this tool gives you a bird's eye view of all the market. And here we will have all the products that are mentioned on this page. And how many products we have here at this point? About 50, 51, 5. And we're going to see them in the bird's eye view. But what we need to do in order to find our brand names, the ones that are good, we're gonna segment it by sales, because we want to see the ones that sell more. Usually these are the ones that are gonna have also higher search volume in their brand names, and we're gonna identify them. But remember, we're also in our course, we're selling a knife, which is not a bundle. It's a knife that costs between about $20 and $30, and it's a singular knife, right? Just remember that we need to find competitors that are similar. You know, you don't really want to be competing with a knife sharpener or a knife that is $13. That's not exactly our kind of knife, although we still might be competing with them, but want to compete and find the keywords relevant to whatever we are selling. And then hence the conversion is going to be higher, because these knives are what people are looking for. And let's just check out the competitors now and see which are good for us or not, and see their brand names. So we have the sharpener here, we have this $13, we have a knife set. All right, we have a $34 knife, which pretty much looks like our knife, you know, like a singular knife, which is a chef's knife and a kitchen knife. And this is by a brand called Victorinox. Now, if you're not familiar with Victorinox, it's a pretty big brand, but let me show you what I do here in Magnet. In Magnet, I'm going to type in kitchen knife to find all the keywords connected to kitchen knife, but I will also include the brand name Victorinox, not exactly here, but in the, once we get all the results in the advanced filters, I'm going to type in Victorinox. I already have it saved here. I click on apply, and we have now 28 keywords, so it's just segmented by search volume. I think it already was. And we have a keyword, Victorinox chef knife. Usually when a brand gets established on Amazon, people are going to search for it as brand name plus product name, or product name plus brand name. So sometimes it's going to be chef knife Victorinox, or it might be, as you can see here, kitchen knife Victorinox. You see, it still gets some search volume, or Victorinox chef knife, Victorinox kitchen knife. Let's go identify. Is it good for us? Do we want to compete against this phrase or this brand? Let's see. We click on open the Amazon. Awesome. We have the keyword. Oh, here, Victorinox chef knife. And we have a choice for this one, but let me show you what's the problem with this keyword. You see all the products here, I buy Victorinox, 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 and Victorinox skips Victorinoxing down the page. And probably you will not have a chance to rank here even, because the brand built really strong authority for this keyword, and it's just the same products, although it's also a huge brand. Victorinox is like really, really big worldwide brand. So the chance that your product is gonna land here and well, that you will rank it, it's gonna be hard for you. And maybe it's not the best idea to, because you see it's down, well, up, down until the all the page is Victorinox. Yes, so chances that you're gonna rank here are really low because the relevancy of this brand here is very high and the authority of this brand in this keyword is very high. So this brand might not be the best for us, but let's continue looking for others. So we're in Amazon here and we stopped on the Victorinox. There's the set, which is not that good for us. And we have the guy Imarco. Remember the Imarco knife, right? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take his brand name here, Imarco, and we're gonna go to the magnet. And instead of using Victorinox as the phrase that contain, we're gonna use Imarco. Perfect. We also have 28 results and we have Imarco Chef Knife, Imarco Knife, Imarco Pro. So in this case, we still have a pretty good volume keyword, which is 1,287 searches per month. And it is a branded keyword, Imarco Chef Knife. There's also probably Imarco Knives. You see Imarco Knife Set, which is not that connected. But Imarco Chef Knife, let's go and open what's there on Amazon for this keyword. And we see that there's Imarco, the same knife, and it's the choice because that's what usually people buy. But what's the nice thing about these competitor keywords, and this one specific, that the next competitors that come are not Imarco. You see there are many like Fantech and Foxel and some MedShark, different knives at all. LaVinci, you see like the brands. Oh, there's another Imarco, yes, just one. And mostly these are different knives. You don't have much of the same brand. And this keyword will be more relevant for us if we wanna use this technique. And again, it's a bit sneaky, but nevertheless, you can use it and try it because there is not much competition here from the same brand. Like, yes, there is search for this brand because as you can see, this brand, this product has about 2,200 reviews. So it means it's been on the market for a pretty long time, been selling well, established some name, but it's not a huge product line like Victorinox. So technically here's going to be easier for us to rank and to show our product here. As you can see, these guys are probably they're using their product name somewhere, either on the front end of the listing or somewhere on the back end. And that's a bit of a sneaky technique. Another sneaky technique that I've mentioned before is actually on your product listing. So let's say that this was our product listing. Let's just get inside this product. Let's say that would be your product listing. How else can you, so to say, take advantage of this competitor name thing? This is even more sneaky, but what you can do is try to index this keyword somewhere in your questions and answers. For example, again, if you get somebody to ask a question for you and you can include the brand name here, and some people even take it a step further and they can leave a link to a specific product, right? And this might give the algorithm again the chance to rank you there. Or sometimes in reviews, you can use this sneaky technique in order to, sometimes you can even link your own products by leaving links, but you can do that in the reviews or in the questions and answers. There is a slight chance that it's also going to rank you because it also gets read in the algorithm, the questions and answers and the reviews and all the stuff. But usually we use it on the back end of the listing. So let me just save this keyword, right? For example, we're going to save Imarco Chef Knife because we did see that it's good. We're going to go to Excel and create some new sheet, and let's call it competitor keywords. Again, this is up to you if you want to use it. It's against TOS. Many people do that. I use that as well, but up to you if you want to try. And then we have the phrase, we have Imarco kitchen knife. You can do the search volume as well. And remember, with the Excel, you're welcome to play as you wish. It's up to you. So let's just save this one. What you want to do is, again, when you're going to be filtering your magnet keywords, you will leave out the brand names. And then if you want to take this technique and this approach, you go and check out which brand names are going to be easier for you to rank for. Again, not super authoritative, huge worldwide brands, gonna be hard, but rather small brands, and you can get a small cut of the pie from there. And now up here, we're gonna find the lesson number 6, where we're gonna be speaking about competitor density, and we're gonna see how we take advantage of density in order to understand our niche better and all this good stuff. So please watch it now. See you there.